What is up, y'all? It is Maddie Andrews here, and welcome to my Mad Art channel. I'm going to be doing painting, arts and crafts, makeup, lifestyle things on this channel. Who's excited? So, first video up, makeup tutorial. I love makeup. It is something that I loved even before I loved painting. So, I thought that would be a great thing to start out with. And today, we're going to be doing this look here. So if you're like, dang, she looks good, and you want to learn how to do this look, and you just love this new Urban Decay palette, because I do, look at this, Born to Run by Urban Decay. Like, come on, ladies, you need this palette in your life, and you need this makeup look in your life, and if you're ready to see me slay this look, keep it. So let's get straight to it. So I'm going to cheat a little. And I'm going to use my Mermaid by Revolution palette, And I'm actually going to use this color right here. I've actually got it flipped upside down. This color right here, I absolutely love this color. Like, I'm obsessed with it. It's hard for me to do an eyeshadow look without this color. So I'm just going to go in with a flat brush like so. I'm going to dampen it a little bit, and then I'm going to go right into that color. It's very white and sparkly. And I'm going to put it on my tear duct. On both eyes. Just to really make my eyes stand out and pop. Now, some people save this step for last. I kind of like doing it first. Just so it blends in with everything else and it's not like this huge white spot on your eye. Okay, and I'm also going to use the same color and go right under my eyebrows. And this is going to be really key to highlight that brow bone. So just go right in with a dampened brush. And if you buy a palette, you know, that the formula isn't very great, dampen your brush and then try the colors. And honestly, it makes a huge difference. The colors become so much more vibrant and so much more visible. Okay, look, already shining. Love it. Okay, so now I'm gonna get right into the Urban Decay palette. And the first color I'm going to be using is going to be a transition color from my sparkly white down to the colors that I'm going to be using. So I'm going to use the color Weekender. It's a very neutral color, and I'm going to use a big brush like so. I'm just going to go right in and just kind of put it right under where we put this sparkly white. It's almost the color of my skin, a little bit darker. So this is our transition color. And what that basically means is you're transitioning from one color to the next. And the top of your lid right here is not going to be super full of color. That is going to be more where you're going to shine and let your eye come through, because we don't want eyeshadow. Well, we're putting eyeshadow all the way to our brow, but we don't want it to look like there's blue shadow all the way to our brow. Okay, so next color that I'm going to use is Riff, which is right here next to this Good As Gone brown. And this is kind of like an orangey brown color. And this is what we're going to be using right under our transition color. And I'm just using the same brush. And in order to do great makeup, you don't necessarily have to have a million different brushes. You can always clean your brushes after every color. Just kind of, you know, wipe it off. And use the next color. But if you want to go all out and buy a million brushes, more power to you. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of sweep it down this way towards my eye just a little bit, just to create that kind of angled look. All right, so now that we have Riff on, we're going to go in with Baja, which is a lot more orangey of a color. It's really gonna stand out and show. And we're gonna do that right under the color that we just did. Now, one thing that I did learn in art that you can transfer to makeup is the color wheel. Colors across from each other on the color wheel really complement each other. And two colors that I'm using today that are across from the color wheel from each other is orange and blue. So we're using kind of like a burnt orange brown shadow, and then we're going to go in on the lid with blue. Awesome, this is looking great. So now we're going to go in with our browns. So we're going to go in with Good as Gone, which is this top color right here. And we're going to do our crease. Blend that sucker in. And you're not going to go all the way across like we did. We're just going to go to the mid section of our eye and down here on the eyelid. Like so. Once again, I'm using the same brush, just kind of wiping it off in between. Beautiful. Alright, now I'm going to go with a little bit darker color, which is this color called Punk. It's a little bit darker brown. And I'm just going to do it right where that color was and not go in as far. Just really make that crease pop and give it some real dimension. One thing that I learned from YouTube is to never put a metallic color on your crease. So, all these colors that I'm using right now are matte colors. And then you can go in on your eyelid with the metallic and the sparkle. And that is really gonna make your eye pop. Okay, so we're looking good so far. I'm actually gonna add a little bit more orange to the top because I feel like it needs a little bit more. Yes, honey. So this Baja color is just so bright and so vibrant. I love it. Ooh. Yes. Alright, now here comes the fun part. Now you're going to take your concealer. Whatever concealer you use is fine. I'm using Maybelline Fit Me 15 Fair Claire, which I love because my middle name is Claire. How awesome is that? And I'm going to take a flat brush, like so. And I'm just going to get some concealer on this brush. Now, this technique that we're doing here is called a cut crease. So, let's learn, ladies. You're going to take your concealer that you put on this brush, and you are going to make an area that you're going to put your next shadow. Okay? Yes. Perfect. Now, the hard part is getting them even. So, get a little more on your brush. The next eye. And try and follow the same shape that you did for the first eye. Awesome. All right, while this is drying on my eyes a little bit, I'm going to actually show you what I use to clean off my brushes. So this is packaging that you get in, I think BoxyCharm has them, and I think that's it. I think it's just BoxyCharm. But basically it's just like this, I don't even know what kind of material this is, but you're looking at it, you're seeing what it is. And I just wipe off the brush, and it does a great job. It cleans the brush, and you're ready for the next color. Okay, speaking of next color, let's get to the next color. Okay, so the next color we're going to use is a Radio, which is this dark teal. I love it. I love teal on my dark hair and my dark eyes. I have brown eyes, so I feel that blues and greens. It really makes my eyes pop. So I'm going to try and do this with a dry brush. But if it does not come out as vibrant as I want it to, I'm just going to wet the brush. But this palette is a great palette, and I really feel that using it dry might actually work. So let's try it. Oh, yes. Okay, so we're just filling in where we made our crease. And we're going to about the center of our eye. Wow, I love this color. Perfect. And the line that you make right here doesn't have to be exactly perfect, because we're actually going to blend another color into it. So, let's do it for this same eye. I mean, the other eye. This is not the same eye. And go to about the middle of your eye. Wow, I love this palette. Like, the formula is amazing. Wow, love it. Okay, so we're gonna wipe our brush off. And I'm going to go into the next color, which is Big Sky. And it is more of like a green, a green blue. It's very metallic. Oh, and these colors that I'm using are metallic colors. So, this is where you would use a metallic color on your eyes. And we're just going to kind of blend in the middle right here. Perfect. And I usually do a lighter color to the center of my eye and then go darker. So we use the darker blue on the outside and then the lighter green on the inside. So I'm going to go back in with my punk color, and I'm just going to kind of make where it was dark a little darker. Just to really give us that definition that we want. Now the next thing I'm doing, I feel like, is key for any makeup eyeshadow look. We did the top lid, it looks fabulous. But to really transform your look, doing your bottom lid really adds some definition and some character to your eyes. I really think it makes them stand out more. So we're gonna go in with this Baja color, the flat brush like so, and I'm gonna go into the very center of my eye right here. We're gonna go about up to the middle where the other two colors on top end. Okay, and then we're going to go back in with our Good As Gone, which is this, almost knocked the whole thing over, this brown color, and we're going to do the end of our eye right here, and just kind of blend those two together. Okay, now the next thing that we're gonna do, we're done with the eyeshadow, here we go. Next thing we're gonna do is eyeliner. Now I'm using a pencil liner. This is, I'm not even sure what kind it is because it has all rubbed off and it is at the very end, but it's a drugstore eyeliner. Some people are great and fabulous at gel liners. If that's you, do it. Do your thing, girl. But especially on camera, I am not as good a gel liner as I am pencil liner. So I'm just gonna go in. I'm gonna do a slight wing. I'm not gonna do anything super dramatic. And then I'm going to do my top lid. And then the bottom. Now, to clean up my wings a little bit, I usually just take an angled brush and I'll wet it a little bit or dampen it and just carry out the wing that I did with the liner. And that just kind of sharpens the end for me. It makes it so much better. Okay. Now for the last part. Eyelashes. And today I'm going to be using some thick lashes. Let me see what. I think they're Broadway. Yes, Broadway. 100% human air. Hair, excuse me, not air. The triple pack. I've already taken them off and cut them to my eye size. You need to do that with any lashes or they're just going to be huge and they're going to kind of fall off the end of your eye. In this pack, actually, I don't know if it was this pack. I'm pretty sure it was. I received a little applicator and I love the applicator. It really helps me place it where it needs to be placed. Sometimes I use my fingers just to help out. But here we go. So I'm using Allure Lash Fix Strip Lash Adhesive. It is the clear color. You can use any kind of adhesive, any eyelash adhesive. Some people like the black adhesive. Some others like the one that dries clear, which is this one that I'm using. There are different brands, of course. And with eyelashes, what you need to do is blow them, air dry them, however you need to do it, for a few seconds. So the glue becomes tacky and it is able to stick to something and gives it a little stick. Okay. I think we are done. Alright, here we go. Now, if you have a mirror, I would suggest placing it low and up, looking into it and applying. So you're not, if it's up here, you're having trouble looking at where you're placing. But if you're looking down here, it's a little easier to place. And the lash looks a little crazy at the moment with the white on it, but it is going to dry clear and look fabulous. Right now for the next eye, do the same as you did. Get that lash tacky. And apply. So wait. Okay, so now I'm going to go in with my mascara and I'm using the Tarteist Tarte mascara. It looks like so. And I'm gonna wait for these to dry a little bit. I'm gonna do my lower lash first while they're drying. And then I'm going to do my upper lash to really connect those lashes together. And make them stick and hold. All right, then I'm gonna go in with my NYX finishing powder. And I'm just gonna sweep my under eye for any excess that fell off onto my under eye. And it just really brightens up your under eye as well. Okay, then we're going to give it a good spray with our finishing spray. I use Mirabella Bulletproof Matte Finishing Spray. It's not the best, that's what I'm using. So, give it a good little spritz. And there you go, ladies. Alright y'all, now that we have slayed this makeup look, I hope y'all all enjoyed the video, and I need you to like, subscribe, and turn on that little bell for notifications for more mad art stuff. So thanks again for clicking, and watching, and subscribing, and being the best mad art fan that there is. Love you guys.